Space, the final frontier. These are the voyages of a new Trekkie. My 5-year mission to search out Star Trek media, to seek out other fans and merchandise, to boldly go where no fan has gone before.
Greetings and salutations, how's everybody doing? So today we're looking at 2 episodes from TNG, in this case the episode The Next Phase, and the episode The Inner Light. Let's look at The Next Phase first. And what actually happened in this episode? Well, the Enterprise responds to a distress call from Romulan's science ship, and Geordi and Ensign Ro learn are lost in a transporter accident when returning to the Enterprise by a faulty generator from the Romulan ship. And at that, like, basically what I just said doesn't, like sounds a little like, wait, what? Basically what happens is, once they, you know, are transported and way back, in a way, they become invisible, so no one can hear them, no one can see them, and in a way, what they're trying to do is try to be like, hey, how do we get all of our friends, anyone else to see us? Because they're basically perceived as,
Have you decided what you're going to say about Ensign Ro?
Yes, I have. Wasn't easy.
Situations like
what?
These are never
what
easy, number
easy?
One.
What?
Having passed an episode. Honestly, I gotta say this is like a pretty good episode when it comes to like the relationship between Ro and Geordi, in that sometimes they don't really have much then we work, like have episodes where they were working together. And I kind of like how, like, as an episode, they're both trying to, in a way, feel like, so is this how we, contemplate death? Is this how we are supposed to, in a way, figure out, you know, like, are we not, in a way? I do like the fact that Geordi is willing, so persistent to get other sisters to see them, and like, heck, they even have, as the episode goes on, a Romulan officer who's chasing after them.
Friend, excuse me, Lieutenant.
Ro!
I'm detecting a chronoton field in your room. Certainly.
Because he wants to become visible again as well. And eventually, he gets thrown out of the ship because he gets pushed and he gets thrown off the ship. And yeah, like, see, the most dramatic moments of this episode are the fact that everyone thinks that they have passed away. And yeah, that is kind of a dramatic idea. Like, what, like knowing, like, say, hey, I know I'm here or something like that, but everyone else thinks that you have gone. Like, you know, that knowing that you wouldn't be able to interact with the loved ones, but you know, you can interact with them. That is kind of a dramatic idea. I mean, I thought this episode was pretty good. Kind of liked it. So now we're looking at the episode The Inner Light, which honestly, I gotta say, this episode was honestly incredible. In this episode, Jean-Luc Picard is stuck unconscious by an energy beam from an alien probe. While minutes away for the rest of the crew, the probe makes Picard experience 40 years of lifetime is Kamen, a humanoid scientist whose planet is threatened by the nova of its sun. The probe is later found to contain a flute, which Picard keeps as a memento for the remainder of the series. Oh my god, this one was extremely powerful. Whether it was in the fact that at first Picard is, you know, thinking, like, say, I don't know if this is really happening, and he is wanting to get back to his friends, the crew, and all that. But eventually, you know, he takes comfort and decides, like, say, you know, I'm here, and all that. And he decides to say, with the relationship he has with Ellen, I think it's Alan, his wife, he is thinking, like, say, he wants to do what she wants to do, which is have a family.
Kamen, you've built your telescope, your laboratory. You don't need my permission for something new.
In this case, I think I do.
What is it?
Nursery.
And the thing that makes this so beautiful is in the fact that, like, you know, as the story goes on, we see him be a father, be a grandfather, and all that. And, like, it's just powerful, whether, like, we see him in the makeup, because that is, like, yes. Yeah, this came out in 1992. The makeup for it is really good.
Seen it? What are you talking about? I haven't seen any missile.
Yes, you have, old friend. Don't you remember?
Die.
You saw it just before you came here. We hoped our probe would encounter someone in the future. Someone who could be a teacher.
Like, you can still see that it's Patrick Stewart. And, like, you know, we have the moments of greatness. Whether it is Kamen as an older man and, like, you know, his daughter becoming married, or his son deciding to, he wants to be a officer, and not officer, but, you know, continue being a musician. And, like, as, like, say, when he is, like, you know, like a very, like a grandfather, he is, like, you know, playing with his grandson. It's honestly, like, you know, the story of the beginning of Up, it reminds me of that. And the fact, you know, this, like, yeah, this is a long episode, but at the same time, it flies by, that it's just so beautifully done.
Yes, my love.
Me.
The rest of us have been gone 1,000 years. If you remember what we were and how we lived, then we'll have found life again.
Whether it is at the end of the episode when we see, I think it's B2, how, like, say, the he sees his, can even see his old friend again, and then they say, hey, we love you all, and that we were trying to get in contact with you, because that what has happened right now is over 440, like, so many years in the past. And eventually, you know, Picard wakes up again. It's honestly, I guess this one was beautifully done. It reminded me so much of the Justice League episode, The Man Who Had Everything, minus the, you know, well, the planet is that he is on is kind of unfortunately fading. From an overall, I thought this episode was beautiful. I'll see you next time.